So we had seen the potential of any positive charge q at a point p with the help of bringing a test charge from infinity to that point. So that we had already seen. Now let us see some important graphs. So these are some important graphs. So now this equation 2.8, what is equation 2.8? this is our equation 2.8. this is our equation 2.8, q upon 4 pi epsilon naught r. Equation 2.8 is true for any sign of charge q, that means whether this is charge positive or negative, though we consider charge q to be positive in this derivation. For q less than 0, that means negative, the potential would be simply negative, because v is equal to q upon 4 pi epsilon naught. So if charge is negative, this potential will also be negative. That is work done by the external force per unit positive test charge in bringing it from infinity to the point is negative. Why it is negative? Suppose this charge is positive, capital Q, and you are bringing a positive test charge, unit positive charge. So you have to work against it. You have to put some work against it because it is repelling it, this charge, test charge. But if this test charge itself is negative, let us say this is negative. So what will it do? It will not repel this, it will attract this. So to remove this attraction, you have to put some work. So work must be in this direction. And if you are working in this direction, that means work in negative direction. Same thing they are saying. The work done by the external force per unit positive charge in bringing it from infinity to the point is negative. For if this q charge is negative, then it is automatically coming in this direction. You are not doing some work, you are just showing that work is done, but work is not done. Work itself is in negative because it itself will move in this direction. Okay, it itself will move in this direction. You don't need to do some work. So hence work itself is being done. Work is itself being done, hence work is negative. This is equivalent to saying that work done by the electrostatic force in bringing the unit positive charge from infinity to the point P is positive. So same thing. So if that charge is positive, then again unit charge bringing from point P to, that means if the charge is positive, then we have to do work. If it is negative, then the work itself is negative. So it is already working in this direction. Hence, if you are working, that work is already being done. So we have seen this, if this charge is there. And another case could be if this is positive and you are bringing a positive charge. So again, the work is positive. If you are bringing a negative charge, it will itself attract. So in this case, work is positive. In this case, work is negative. You are just showing that work is done, but work is not done. Work itself is being done. Second case, this Q is negative. You are bringing a negative charge. Then you have to do some work against the repulsive force. But if you are bringing a positive charge, the work is negative. You are just showing the work is done, but work itself is being done. You don't need to do any extra work. So same thing is written here. Now this is at, should be, since q is less than 0, the force on a unit positive test charge is attractive, that you know, so that the electrostatic force and the displacement from infinity to P are in the same direction, that also you know. So if forces are attractive, so the direction of the force, electrostatic force, and direction of bringing this are in same direction. Finally, we note that equation 2.8, that equation written above, is consistent with the choice of potential at infinity to be 0. Again, we can choose potential at infinity to be 0. That means previously, as we saw, that we can take 0 point anywhere. So this is also consistent. Now this figure is important and it has come in the exam several times. So So what is this figure? This figure, how does E electric field and potential changes with distance? Okay, so you saw that E is simply 1 by r square. E is simply 1 by r square and potential is equal to, is proportional to 1 by r. So potential decay much slower. This is slow. This is 1 by r. This is fast. Electric field decay much faster than the potential. So see, this is potential. Blue line is potential. So this potential, as you can see, that it is decaying very slowly, very slowly. This is slow. So it will reach to this point at much higher distance. While electric field is decaying very fast and very soon it touches to zero. So electric field decays very fast while potential does not decay that fast. Why? Because potential has 1 by r dependence. While electric field, this is electric field, this is 1 by r is potential. See how fast the electric field is decaying from this to this. It is almost 0 at this 5. But potential is still not 0 at this point, but going down and will go 0 at much higher distances. So that is a relation. So this graph is generally comes in your exam. So please make this graph in your copies. Now let us do this example 2.1. Calculate the potential at a point P due to a charge. This charge Q is equal to 4 into 10 to power minus 7 coulomb located 9 centimeter away. Okay. Now hence obtain the work done in bringing a charge. This charge is 2 into 10 to power minus 9 coulomb from infinity to that point P. Does the answer depend on the path along which it is brought? So first of all, if you compare these two charges, this charge is big, quite big, and this is very small. Why? This charge is small, so if you bring this charge, this small charge, it will not disturb the position of the big charge. So let us solve. So first we have to calculate the potential. So the formula for potential, 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught charge Q upon R. So charge is Q, which is 4 into 10 to power minus 7, and R. So this 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught is 9 into 10 to power 9 Newton per meter square per coulomb square into, why this is coulomb square? Because there is another test charge which is positive. So again, this charge Q is 4 into 10 to power minus 7 coulomb, and this is simply 9 centimeter. 9 centimeter is equal to 0.09 meter. So we have converted into meter. When we calculate, this cancels out, 10 to power 9 and 2 power from here, 10 to power 11 and 10 to power minus 7. So 10 to power 11 into 4 into 10 to power 7 minus 7. This is simply 4 into 10 to power 4 volt. So this is the potential at 9 centimeter away from this charge, bigger charge. So this, if this is charge, big charge, so 9 centimeter away from this, this is the potential at this point. Now second thing is that work done. So work done is simply, so what was the potential? Potential was simply W upon Q. Now work done is simply Q into V. So that they have done. So Q already, we have calculated. So this Q is 2 into, let me remove this thing first. So this is small Q. So this is a small Q. 2 into 10 to power minus 9 coulomb. And we already have calculated, this is 4 into 10 to power 4. When we calculated, 2 into 4, 8, 9 and 4 minus 5. So work done is 8 into 10 to power minus 5 joule. Again, this, the unit is volt, here the unit is joule. No, work done will be path independent, that we had already seen. Any arbitrary infinitesimal, that means very small distance, path can be resolved into two perpendicular displacements one along with r and another perpendicular to r, the work done corresponding to the latter will be zero. So we will discuss it sometime after this. So but for the now, you know that work done is independent of path. Thank you very much.